hair toes, check my nails. Baby, how you feel? Is this a little on the nose? What do you guys think? Raquel back. You the first one at the party. Hi, Kristen. Hi, Tasha. Hi, Nicole, Christine. Unfortunately, Morgan. There's nothing unfortunate about that. I do my hair tough. Check my nails. Baby, how we feel? Feeling good as hell. A little tired. For no reason. Hi, friends. You guys. I tried on 7 different outfits before I chose this tank top. Phoning it in. I had a cute outfit on. I had a cute shirt on. Let's not be crazy. I'm not going to put on a full outfit for you guys. Mostly because I still want to be me. But we're good. I didn't want to get too hot. And I'm already hot, so I feel like I've made the right decision. I don't even know where this tank top came from. Look at how wrinkly it is. I still care. I know everybody's still getting here. You guys, hi. Thanks for coming. Thanks for being here on this Thursday. I love having these parties. I look forward to them every week. I mean, I will be honest and say every week I go, can I do it? I don't know. Because, well, we'll get to this later. Every week, kind of like right on cue, I have this, what the fuck is going on? As I'm sure you all are. And we're all trying to get used to this kind of life because we don't know how long it's going. But then Thursday comes and I do my setup, as Valentina calls it, which makes me laugh. And then I just have the best time. Victoria! Okay, I want to talk about Victoria for a second. Look at my glam. Again, you guys won't notice, I'm wearing the most makeup on the entire planet. Like, I put it on at 3 o'clock and I was like, whoa! But look at those freckles. Those are from Victoria. I mean, they're not from her. She's not here. But she taught me how to do them. And now I love doing them. Aren't they fucking cute? That's enough of the close-up. I know, I love that wallpaper too. It's from Etsy. We did it last year when we decided that we weren't going to move. We're in a very inexpensive apartment and our neighbors who live upstairs are awesome and we don't want to leave. And so we're not going to, so we just redecorated instead. Makeup tutorial, no. You know why? Because I'm lazy. But speaking of laziness, let's talk about alcohol. Just kidding. Those two aren't related. You can be a high-functioning alcoholic, which I'm not. As some of you know, I keep my drinking during this pandemic to 3 days, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, because early on, yeah, Janelle, look at, can you see that upper lip? Already sweating. I realized that I was drinking a lot. I needed to not drink so much. I wasn't drinking a lot. I was actually drinking a lot less, but I was drinking every day. And Jose is working during the day, doing landscaping, which is awesome because not many people are able to work and he's helping out a friend's business and it's awesome. So I'm with Valentina all day and all night. I mean, he comes home at night, but. I needed to be a little more with it, and I found that I was just feeling sluggish. And same thing with, I talk about with you guys with exercise. I'm just like, I don't like the feeling of not feeling strong, especially at this time. So I decided just to drink 3 days a week, and also, frankly, gave me something to look forward to. Okay, so you guys might have seen on internet, a video of Mr. Stanley Tucci making a cocktail, and I fucking trolled him. He never saw it because he's famous and important. But I thought I would try to make my own Negroni. Yeah, it's Negroni day. We're getting it done. Okay, so something I also realized, remember when I made last words last week? This is a double shot, as I learned from his video. I thought it was just like a big shot. So my cocktail last week had 6 ounces of alcohol in it. So I had no wonder I felt a little hungover the next day. That's okay. So we're going to do it. Like, I'm going to try to be cool like he does it, because he looks cool and fucking hot. So he's all, you know, you just throw in some gin. Like 2 ounces is, oh, that's the wrong spot. I was going to throw it in the glass. I fucking failed already. No. Okay. So I got some ice in there already. You guys, I'm not going to spill. I did it. Then I don't want gin on my bedroom floor again. You guys remember the first episode, gin and Sonic everywhere. Campari. Sorry, I'm supposed to be doing this as well. I'm terrible at this. Bombay Sapphire. It's the gin we have. And this is Campari. Big fan of Campari. Some people don't like Campari because it's kind of bitter. I like it because it reminds me of me. Oh, I love when I make myself laugh like that. You gotta laugh. So I'm using the other side, which I guess is a single ounce. Boring. But we'll see how it tastes. I'm doing it the Stanley Tucci way. Sing it, Gaga. I was born this way. Cinzano. Which he said not to use. But again, what I got. So I did 2 ounces of gin, 1 ounce of Campari, 1 ounce of Cinzano. We're gonna see how this tastes. Because I have lots of alcohol in this house. So if it's no bueno, we try something else, okay? Oh, you guys, also, unrelated, I'm gonna shake it, which I didn't normally do because apparently you're not supposed to shake gin because it bruises the gin. I'm gonna shake it. Guys, I started watching The Sopranos. Can we talk about late to the motherfucking party? It is a beast. Not only because the season one incredibly dated, but because it's a lot of television watching. How does he do it? Why does he look so cute when he does it? He doesn't really shake it, that's why. Where I'm like, he's all, it's cold though. Look how cold that is. Who does that? Enough of that. And guys, not to be extra, hey Stanley, I see your glass and I raise you another glass. Oh, pretty. I wouldn't throw that out of bed. Hello. And then what we're gonna do, somebody's an influencer. How do I do this? Okay, so he does it like a wedge. He's all plop. I don't know about that. I heard you're supposed to do a fucking whatever this is called. Guys, what's this called? A thing. And then you give it a little, it's like a twist, right? Oh, twist. There we go. And then I'm just going to throw it in. Sure. There you go. And there you have your Stanley Tucci Negroni. This will be gone in 2 minutes. Cheers, my people. I love you guys. I miss you. I hope everybody's surviving out there. That makes me feel sexy and bald. Yes. That's a delicious cocktail. That's very good. I'm glad that I left all of the liquor in here because I might make a second one. That brings us to snacks. Guys, last week we had cookies by John. Yeah, it's my mailman. John brought me cookies. They were fucking delicious. Don't think I didn't hide them from my daughter. Today, we have the pretzels, because I love a pretzel with an alcoholic beverage. Look at these. I mean, they look weird. This is homemade beef jerky we got at the farmer's market. I cut it up in little pieces because I can't chew it that well because I'm a senior citizen. And then we also have these, which look like little pieces of poop, but they're actually dried apricots. I'm going to have those. Now, if this snack looks like a pussy snack to you, I get it. But I'm going to eat directly after this live video. So it's really just here to like sop up the booze a little bit. So that's my story about the alcohol and food. I want to know what you guys are eating, drinking. Mint chip ice cream. Go, Pamela. Yes, little poop nuggets. Thank you. Thank you, Thera. So this is the portion of the episode where I like to do your top shitty things of the week and top awesome things of the week. So let's start with the shitty things of the week. Because I think it's important that during this time, we don't try to make it something that it's not. Meaning, if you feel shitty, fucking feel shitty. It's okay to feel shitty. If you don't feel shitty, enjoy that. Don't feel guilty about that. So here we go. Oh yeah, that's good. Yes. Guys, I'm not gonna lie. I'm gonna set up another cocktail right away before this ice melts. Guys, I know, I'll get to your questions in a second. I know, it just like, a priority. Woo! Does anybody have any requests? Shitty school, great. Spending time with my kitties, I love that. Goose isn't in here terrorizing me. I totally get that. So here's a shitty thing, but is not a shitty thing. So I think that, who's playing in the background? This is from the movie. Did anybody watch that movie I talked about last week? Ibiza? This is from Ibiza. Sophie Tucker. It's like DJ music. I'm trying to get into DJ music. I'm trying to be cooler, you guys. Okay, here's the thing. So my industry is shut down a little bit, meaning film television is kind of shut down. What is alive and well is the voiceover industry. So I feel very lucky. I have a little setup here. I have pop filter. I have a home like sound booth. I have everything I need. But you know what? I don't have the capacity to work that well right now. Partly because Valentina is here. And so I always have to like give her a cartoon and my brain is split. You know how that is. There's alcohol everywhere now. I had to do an on-camera audition yesterday, which was awesome, but also, what? What cameras? Who's shooting anything right now? I know. It's just who I am. Let it go. So that was strange and not bad, but weird. And I had such weird feelings about it. I was like, there's a lot of things right now. People have been asking me to do things and all of these things are awesome and other people are doing them. And that kind of makes me feel left out, even though I've said no to them, because I don't feel like it feels good to me. It doesn't feel natural to me. And that's my stuff. That's just like where I'm at. I'm trying to like really hone in with where I'm at right now. And so it felt weird to do an on-camera audition. And also I thought, wouldn't this be hilarious if this was the thing I booked? What did it take for Brianna to get a job? A global pandemic. Oh, that's going down real fast. Okay. Let me look at my notes. Yes, I have notes. Yes, the hell zone. Let's talk about the hell zone. I don't know if you guys are experiencing this, but the hell zone is where everything is fucking tickety-boo. and you think that you are mastering your ability to navigate your feelings, your mental stability, your physical self in this pandemic, and then you have a day where you go, what the fuck? Can't function. That was yesterday for me. And it wasn't bad. I didn't have like a crazy spiral, but I definitely was like, check. Like, are we done? Are we done now? Is this a bit? Are we doing a bit, planet? Where I was like, oh, fuck. Like, this is not going away anytime soon. And I keep thinking, sorry, wiping the sweat from my brow, that it's going to go away. And it's not. Well, it will. Sorry. It will go away. Just not anytime soon. And so I'm trying to wrap my head around that and trying to like build a life that is this as normal for now. Because I also don't want to wish away my days, you know? I'm doing that a lot. I said to Jose, it was like last night, we're just like, I was like, can I go to bed now? Like, I just wanted the day to be over. But like, then you're fucking 60 and whatever. I'll never be 60. I'll always be 38. Yes, I'm 38 years old. Goddamn proud of it. Because I act like a 16-year-old. Okay. I'm going to try to go through here. Oh, wait. Good things. Let's talk about good things of the week. One of the good things was introducing my daughter to Les Mis. So my daughter's not good with movies, and we've started watching like movie musicals with her because she seems to like those. She doesn't like cartoon movies or anything like that. So we watched Sister Act. Did I tell you guys that last week? Oh my God, it was the best thing. I wept because Sister Act 2 was like one of the movies that made me want to be in musical theater. And Les Mis was the musical my mom took me to when I was 11 that made me go, I want to be on Broadway. I want to be a musical theater star. And so I had her watch it and she was glued to it. And it was like, I don't know, such a moment for me where I was like, oh my God, I'm a mom to this girl. And I've said this before, and point being is like, I was never sure I wanted to be a parent. I was never sure I wanted to be a mother, but I knew I was meant to be her mother. And it feels very special to do stuff like that. And the amount of time that I'm getting to spend with Valentina during this time, it's something universal in the energy was meant to happen for me, because we had been apart so much over the last three, four years maybe. And now we're together at the hip, and it's kind of amazing. And I feel very grateful for that. So that's my gratitude and my go fuck yourselves of the week. Cheers to that. Have I thought about adding color to your tats? Patches, 884, I for sure thought that said tits. And I was like colored tattoos? No, you won't see them any better. They're little. They're wee. And color? No, I'm not a color girl. My tattoos are moments. Some people think about tattoos as art in their life. Mine are memories. And so I get tattoos for the story. I really do everything for the story in my life, you guys. But yeah, my tattoos are, for the story. Guys, can you see this? Hold on. Oh, it stopped. My eye has been twitching for... Oh, wait. Is that weird? You can't see it. My eye has been twitching for 6 weeks. So that's good. How'd you get your hair so curly? I washed it today. And then, you guys, I haven't been putting heat on it at all. I don't think I put... I put it in hot rollers a couple times, but... That heat's pretty good for your hair. So this is just what happens, I guess, when you're good to your hair. And that's it. I didn't blow dry it, doing anything. I mean, I've done this a bunch, but that's about it. That happens to me. It's stress. I don't believe you. Next, drink more water. Shut the fuck up, Mel. Let's see. How about duty called? Somebody had to pee. That's cool. 333. That's how many people are watching. Good luck. Big into that shit. okay. Well, I'm gonna have this and some snacks before somebody special enters our chat. But now is the time, my friends, if you want to ask questions, because I won't have time for them after. skipped washing my hair for 2 weeks. Good for you. When I was pregnant, I never got greasy hair, weirdly, ever. I only washed my hair once my head started to itch. Is that gross? Tough. It's me. It's who I am. Will Kim and you continue to do your podcast? Yes. Yes is the answer to that. Kim and I are navigating this. We both are like suddenly primary caregivers, teachers, wives, mothers. Our plates are full and I want to prioritize things properly because, again, we don't know how long this is going to be and I need to make sure everybody's okay. I'm also like reconnecting with friends and making sure friends who I haven't been around for a lot just, you know, geographically are okay and nobody needs anything. And that feels really good too. I'm trying to just go what feels good. And this live is one of those things. Like, I know some of you have like asked me to go on Cameo and to do stage its and things like that. I don't feel super comfortable doing that stuff right now. That's just me. And that's okay because I love all the people that are doing them and I love that they are doing them because it provides something for you guys, for anybody who wants it. But this is what I have to offer and this feels like it feels good to me, for me, and it feels like I'm also being of service to other people. So I hope that's the case. There's a gin on my counter. Love the song. I know. I love the song too, but I'm going to change it because I've sang it so many times. I need something else. But if you have any, can you see your ring? Guys, it's a motherfucking lion. I got this in Rome at the Gooch because I saw it and it wasn't that expensive considering it was from the Gooch. It's not real gold costume jewelry. But the boys got one. I think Rich and Matt both have one, like in the man version, which is like pewter or something. Let's find a fun song for you to listen to. That's a good one. Fucking Lord. We ordered different drinks at the same bars. Same bar, different drink. Michaela, what's up? What are you bitching about now? This is Gold Top is giving me life. You know what? I'm assuming that that's Emily. I found it. I don't know whose it is. It's not mine. Just found it. Michaela, let's find what your Gucci ring. Oh, you like the Gucci? Yeah, that's good. No more. How are you doing? I'm okay. Fine. Hello, Emily. Keep getting these fucking emails. Lay off. I am in a show right now. What if people play the piano? Do people used to play the piano like this? Okay, let's take some piano. Focus. This is a great song. Hi, Bailey. I love your energy. You can have it too. You can. I mean, I was gonna make a joke about drinking and eating too much sugar, but I consciously make a decision to give my energy out because I recognize that it's big and bright, and I'm a Cancer and a Cancer rising, so I'm very sensitive, and if my feelings get hurt, I have the tendency to wall up. So I do a lot of practice, and we will get into this, I hope, with Lisa. I do a lot of work to clock what is my responsibility, what is about me, and what isn't. And I think that's something that we should all do. We talked last week about how I started taking morning walks. Still doing that. Don't fucking troll me. I'm kidding. This is my friend. I'm making fun of him. Because I said I didn't take my phone. But I do take my phone because I have a child and I need to have my phone with me at all times. I go for a 40-minute walk every morning, rain or shine. And it is my walking meditation. Because it sets my mind straight. I don't listen to music. I just wake up, put on some pants, ideally, and go. And I think, and then I go, I don't think, but I try to let thoughts happen. And then I'm curious about the thoughts. I try to be like, why am I thinking that? Why am I not thinking that? But also, like, today was the best because last night I fucking had a dream about Brad Pitt. And a little while ago, before the pandemic, I auditioned for a show that he produces. And I was like, oh, that'd be fucking dope. And then last night I had a dream that he dragged me on stage at, like, at an award show at the Golden Globes or something. And it was the best dream I've had in a long time. So I was like, I'm going to go for a walk and I'm going to meditate on this. I meditated so hard. I'm a Capricorn. I'm a Capricorn moon, which is why I identify so much with my work self, which is something I need to keep tabs on. Guys, I really killed it with this Negroni. I know I look like an asshole making it. Stanley Tucci's a professional, and he's probably like a mythological god of some kind. I'm not. I know you guys say that about me sometimes to be funny and nice, but I'm basically wearing sweatpants over here. And I like it. Stories behind your tats. Yes, we'll do tarot after. Maybe with Lisa. Rising. Cancer rising. Capricorn moon. If nobody's ever done their chart, do it. Because your sun sign tells you such a small part of your personality. You need to know it all. It can be confusing, but it's fascinating. I don't know what we're listening to, but it is. This is my daughter's playlist. You'll notice there's no children's music in it. It's all just like music like this. What does she love? Like, this is the shit she listens to. She's so cool. In an uncool way. How do you do it? Like this? Party in the house. Is going to bed. Says goodnight. Goodnight, Alexandria. Thanks for joining us. Shit, I almost forgot. Sorry. Forgetting is hard. I'm just trying to keep up with these questions. Let's see. Did I miss anything? Like to know, like, what some of you are. Some of you who I know well, I'd be very curious to know your charts. Hey, if you guys aren't going to Ryan Heffington, ryan.heffington, not every morning, but most mornings at 10 a.m., you're fucking missing out. I am there. I am giving her. I am dancing. I am sweating. And I am like, I think that there's something about dancing and singing that sends out, that rids yourself of negative energy and sends out good energy beyond yourself and your realm. I think it's kind of important in a weird way. So if you have the capacity, and ability to do either of those things, fucking do them, because I think it's important right now. Okay, Aquarius. Yes, Emily, you're very much an Aquarius. I mean that in the best way. That's why we get along. Gemini. Ooh, Kim's a Gemini. Yes, Kristen, get the CoStar app. You're gonna do the Gish hunt? No! Gish is hard! Only people like Misha, who's a fucking genius, can do Gish. I can't. My scalp is sweating just thinking about it. Leo. You would think I'm a Leo, but I'm not. I feel like I should be on the cusp, and I'm not. Is that an aggressive dance? It's for you guys. I don't have a single fire sign in my chart. Me neither. Maybe? Oh, I have Leo and Venus. That makes sense. Venus and Leo, rather. You live for me and Misha's friendship. I mean, it's there, but it's not like, don't live for that. Live for many other things. I'm assigned to a group named Opt Out. I love that. I love you guys are talking about astrology right now. I'm so into it. I have a book, which is a digital book, so I don't know what I'm looking for right now. I'm like, oh, let me show you this book that's on my internet by Chani Nicholas. If you guys don't follow Chani Nicholas, do it. Chani, C-H-A-N-I. She has a book that teaches you how to read your own chart. She's amazing. She's also like incredibly outspoken about LGBTQ. She's brilliant. I think you should follow her. Hold, please. Hold on. Mark Shepherd is on live? Oh, boy. Wait, Brianna, I bought tarot cards last week because of you. Good! I'm on the cusp. Okay, tarot cards are good. Okay, hold on. Yes! Oh my god,
you're hilarious.
Who's prettier than you?
You.
No one.
Look at you.
We're all pretty in different ways. I'm going to take off the party rock anthems and put on something different. You guys, Lisa Berry. Oh, good Lord. Now, I've seen you recently. Because I have, but you have been off of the, should we put on something cute and sweet? Yes.
Go for it.
This is for you. A little Otis Redding.
Oh, I love it. Go for it.
That's how strong my love is.
This is so great. I've never done a live thing like this before. I was like, how's this all going to work?
I don't know how I did it. You know how I discovered that I could have guests was, Jason Manz was doing a live once and I was trolling him and they were like, would you like to join his Instagram live? And I was like, fuck yes. And so I did. And he was like, and I was like, here I am. So I was like, what if I did that on purpose? How we roll. And I love it. And it's great. And I always knew that I wanted to have you on, but I know that you've been off social media. So I didn't want to obviously invite you on and you be like, no, I'm clearly not going to do that right now. I've set some boundaries, Brianna.
Oh my God. I love you.
So how are you?
I think I'm doing okay. You know, I think I'm in the general wash of, you know, just feeling a whole bunch of emotions like everybody else. Some, you know, have just received, you know, some pretty harsh news just with friends and close family members of being, you know, people being sick and being in the hospital and people passing away. And
yeah,
it's just been a lot of that. So it's just been kind of managing.
It's kind of this strange, as we were talking about a new normal of going, our new normal is going, are you healthy?
Right.
You know what I mean?
Which it should have always been, but.
And I have been, I mean, yes. I think that what, and there's a hilarious Broad City meme that's like, how am I? How am I? Which is how I feel whenever I ask somebody how they are. So nobody's amazing right now, which is okay. So I feel genuine when I ask people how they are, but I don't expect necessarily people to tell me how they are. Isn't that funny? So that was, I think, a very genuine response from you.
Yeah.
And I think that's funny that we all feel the need to protect other people's emotions or stuff around negative responses in order to not, you know, to not make them feel put off by it.
Fair.
But you didn't do that. And I respect that because it also made me go, oh yeah, I've had a lot of people be sick in my life too. And it's hard. You're right. But what's not hard is the awesome thing that's growing in your belly.
No.
Show us!
A little bump.
Yes!
Baby bump. I know.
I
know, it's like I'm at that I waddle stage. Who knew?
Can you believe it? Can I you waddle. Believe it?
Never thought I'd utter the words, truthfully.
I just this is a thing that Valentina's dad and I share, is we believe babies are good luck. And so I think that this baby, and you and I have talked about this because we've talked since you've found out you're pregnant, but I think that this baby for you was like so meant to be. And I was never sure. We never had the conversation. I'm very sensitive to not ask women if they want to have kids because right. There's so much complexities around that.
Yeah.
So I guess I made the assumption, which is a lesson for me, that you didn't want to have kids. And here you are. And I was like, I couldn't think of a better person to parent a child, especially right now.
Oh wow! Honestly. Well, I'll be straight. I kind of subliminally got people into that frame of mind. I just, you know, like when you let something go out of your system, you know what yeah. I mean? It just takes it out of the air in general. And so, if I was talking about it often, or if I was even thinking about it often, it would be something that people would talk to me about. And I kind of really did gauge how well I was doing with, you know, just being neutral about everything, because I wanted yeah. to be neutral about it, because I was like, well, I don't know. But if I say yes or no, then I've really put something out into the universe. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I really That's wanted interesting. To be neutral about it. And I would be able to tell whether or not I was actually being neutral as if people would talk to me about it. So it went from, you know, everybody being like, so, to, hey, man, what's going on? How you yeah. doing? And it just never coming up. So that's when I knew, I was like, okay, I found a neutral ground. And, you know, real honesty here is like, you know, we tried 3 years ago. And that's when I kind of knew I wanted to, when I couldn't get pregnant.
Yeah.
And I was like, every month that I would get my period, I'd be like,
And then you realize you have emotions about getting
yeah.
your period.
Yeah. And you're like, oh.
I hear that actually from a lot of women who are like, either way. And then they get their period and they're like, that's not what I wanted. And then you realize
you actually do want it. So, you know, I mean, this is not me saying, you know, if you feel called to get like IVF or you need to do treatments or whatever, but I really am somebody who know this. I'm like always about like the spiritual avenue first. And then that's when I started doing a whole bunch of meditations on just fertility and being fertile and just blessing my womb and, you know, and just taking on good energy and really kind of stepping that up in my life. And then we did a spiritual retreat together.
Yes.
And then we came back preggers.
Like literally everybody goes off to a spiritual retreat or never, ever in their entire lives.
But,
so I'm going to ask you questions and be like, and I trust that you'll be straight up and be like, I don't want to go there. So Lisa and I actually met We actually met like, I don't know. I want to say like, 15 years ago.
102.
We both had the same agent and we both lived in Toronto and used to audition for musical theater all the time because that's where the majority of our career was at that time. Yeah.
We're trying to make.
I'll never forget. We took like, we were in Mississauga auditioning for some dinner theater.
Yeah.
And, and both of us were just got the worst responses, I think, from these directors. And we're just like, we're the worst. Fuck those guys. Which is not true. Rejection is redirection. We all know yeah. that now. But we were, I'll internalize this. I was 20 and angry and probably like a bit expectant, you know.
I was straight up bitter.
Yeah. So anyway,
they
so
were, they know were
that
wrong
woman, every time I ran into you, I was like, there's something about this woman that I like, but it was definitely a different woman than I know now. Did you have something where you were like, I'm going to change. I need to change. I know for me about 2 years ago, I had a breaking point where I was like, I can't make it through this life the way I'm doing it, which is where I started to embrace spirituality and meditation and consciously observing my thoughts and actions. Mm-hmm. Did you have something similar to that?
Yep. You're going right
or not, or not.
Right in there.
Just to preface everybody that's watching this is like, I don't like call Lisa and go, how do you feel about this question? How do you feel about this question? I have people on the show that'll be like, Brianna, fuck off, which is totally fair.
Hello.
Yeah.
No, it's actually, I'm actually at a place where I'm finally ready to talk about it. And it's why, you know, I'd written a post the other day where I felt ashamed by somebody. And I was like, I'm really done, you know, having my shame be something I suffer in silence about. And I'm really done, you know, not being authentic. And I have to give permission to people to be like, Lisa, you loser, you bitch, you know, whatever, fill in the blank. And just share whatever it is that has led me to this point. And shame around a lot of the things that I've done, because I'm certainly not perfect, you know, is the reason why I started doing this work. And I was just like, well, if I really start stepping up why I did this work, and I'm working on a course, and, you know, and I'm, you know, just doing more in that area, I had to get over the shame that I felt around what prompted me to do all of this work. And I, you know, for years, like in this business, I'd suffered from jealousy. And it blew up, you know, about a good 6 years ago, where I'd lost a really good friend. And I realized in that moment, I was like, if you keep going this way, you're never going to have any friends. You're going to really, truly, you're going to be walking down a path where you're just bitter, jaded, and alone. Because you just are not willing to be happy for other people. You're not willing to do the work that it takes to get over your own demons, to feel your own worthiness. And so that was the big catalyst for doing this work. And then, like, just specifically, like, even doing breath work came from not understanding how, you know, like, people would be like, you know, you've got to have faith and you got to trust and you got to be all of these things. And I was like, so what do I do with my hands?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
If you could just lay it out real simple, because right now I'm hot. Do you understand? Like, I want to punch somebody. So, like, what do I do, like, right now? Yeah. So that's where all of that work came from. And, like, just being an actor, somebody who's had to, like, crawl inside their skin so often, I realized I was taking notes and gathering valuable data on, like, I'm having an emotional breakdown right now. Mm-hmm. And my toes are curled. Or they're like, my shoulders are becoming earrings, or like, just relax. Like, I started to physically become aware of where I was holding the tension that made it possible for me to stay in a certain state of being that only gave me access to, you know, the thoughts that made me feel like shit. Versus once I realized, oh, when I get angry or when I feel jealous, it shows up in my shoulders and in my jaw. And when I start releasing that, I start feeling better. And then I have access, like I've opened a door to other emotions that actually make me feel better.
Yeah.
And so I really was like,
So kind of the steps for you were like, I mean, for me, it was like, I can't do this anymore. Yeah. I will crash and burn. And then starting to observe and be curious of.
Yeah.
Does that sound right?
And I actually did crash and burn several times.
People do.
Like, I had to crash and burn a couple of times, you know, which is why when I made that post, I was like, look, man, I am trying my damnedest to be a really good person.
I related so much to that post. And I just think that I remember chatting with, hilariously, my woman who gives me facials, Amanda, she's a fucking genius at Glow Therapy. And I was just saying how I was having struggles with people who are like calling me out on being too much all the time. And she was like, Brianna, it is important to be polarizing. And I was like, that's interesting. Because I always thought I needed to please everyone and make sure everyone was okay. And I realized that I was abandoning myself in ensuring that everyone else was okay.
Right.
So that's kind of the work I've been doing over the last few months, certainly. But also, I think that what I'm hearing you say is that you're like, in the relation to the post you were talking about is – you were trying to be authentic to yourself and somebody else was hurt by it.
Yeah. I was like, look, man, I have boundaries around social media, as you know. And a lot of times, very specifically with social media, I set a timer a lot So when the timer goes off, it's done. And I could be in the middle of replying to something. I could be in the middle of, you know, writing something. And it's like, nope, you done. Shut it off.
Out.
And then, you know, you get an email that comes up, you know, an hour later, you know, just when you're about to go back and you totally lose track of it. And it's completely harmless, completely innocent. And it took me off guard because there really, truly was no malice behind it. Like, I wasn't like, I'll get to you later. Anyway.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, there really was no malice behind it. So when somebody was just like, this whole persona you have, I was like,
yeah, I mean, let's just say, like, when I'm a big fan of I speak, which is like, I'm feeling this, or when you did this, it made me feel this, as opposed to you did this to me.
Mm-hmm.
Which is simply, that is gaslighting, and it's eliciting a reaction. I've been in many relationships like that.
Right.
But what I tend to do now is I go, what am I responsible for?
Right.
So in this case, let's use that as an example. I assume if it was me, I'd feel responsible for not responding with something. If it was somebody that I loved and cared about and wanted to make sure they felt loved and cared for. But also, like, I'm a big fan these days of hoping other people take responsibility for their side of the sidewalk.
Yeah.
And that's what I saw in that post, was I was like, oh, that person is not going, why does her not responding to me, why does that make me feel these things? Why is that activating my system, you know?
Yeah.
Did you do anything?
Yeah, I sent her a message back. You know, it was very, very, I set the intention. I was like, I just want this message to be filled with as much love as possible, the love that's in my heart. And I truly mean no disrespect. And then I just wished her well, you know? And I was just like, I guess that's how you see things. And I don't see it that way. And, you know, I don't think I've been a horrible person. I don't believe I have a persona. This is your perspective of me, and you're completely entitled to that. But the four agreements is something that I have, you know, turned into my Bible in the last 5 years. So, you know, once I truly did, like, you know, like, calm down after being like, no, she did. You know what I mean? Like, because you want to.
I will cut a bitch.
Desperately go there, right?
Yeah.
And
yeah.
I just was like, I took a step back, and immediately, like I said, like, once I released the tension that was just like coursing through my body, and I let the heat kind of settle down, all of a sudden it was just like, don't take anything personally. It's actually got nothing to do with you.
It doesn't. And I talk about this all the time, where even when people are like, this does have to do with you, I am upset because of you, it still doesn't have to do with
you. It still has nothing to do with you. And then I realized, you know, once I got over the judgments and all of that, then I really did go into practicing forgiveness. And I was just like, I can't imagine how you must feel right now, because you clearly are not getting the support that you need. You're not feeling loved. You're not feeling like you have a community. And someone like myself, who we don't speak to on a regular basis at all, could cause so much pain in you. And I'm sorry for that pain, you know, because it also just made me 10 times more grateful for the fact that I'm like, I have such a strong community of friends.
Mm-hmm.
I have such a support system, and I feel so loved by people. And I learned from that post. I even said it when I replied to his, I'm like, I'm actually going to work on that. And I, ever since that post, have really been like, you know, picking up my phone, and the minute somebody sends me a message, I was like, let me just reply right here, right now, you know,
or just go, I hear you.
Or just send a quick message. Later. I got to respond later. Or I even send messages now where I'm like, no stress on responding right away.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because I'm aware that we're all kind of on different vibes right now. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
So, you know,
and also, like, not attaching to a desired expectation, response, outcome. These are things we learn when we're doing the work, right?
Mm-hmm.
We go, this is where I will find peace, is just not detaching, but not attaching, non-attachment,
exactly.
Right?
Yeah.
So Lisa is like, between Lisa and Kim and myself, the three of us can have conversations that are very like, and then this happened. We're like, we get really into it. But Lisa, you've been setting up an online practice. I know you have something with creation, right? Or did?
We did one. It was a meditation and we did so good. We raised over $1,000 for St. Michael's Hospital.
Oh, I'm
so
whoa.
Incredibly like blown away by that. And I'm just like, I can't, I never thought I'd be one of those people who I'm like, look at this check. I mean, I feel like I'm writing $1 million check, but to me, that's
you
like
should.
Huge. That's huge.
Always.
I'm just like, oh my God. And it's going to be such a great help. And so, it was just an opportunity to kind of get out there and just kind of share in a way that, you know, like I said, I'm trying to come out and step out in that light a little bit more and to have people, you know, feel better. And the general consensus was
people were like, right?
I generally felt healed, you know, in areas where I could finally meditate for the first time because it wasn't so, you know, ethereal, you know, it was.
And also like practical. Right now there's, I think especially there is a lot of social media right now because we're all, that's where we go to feel connected and that's okay. I'm on social media a lot, but I curate my social media. It's very like, I follow things that I know are going to inspire me. I unfollow things that are not bad. I unfollow things and people that activate my system in a negative way.
Yeah.
And then I, you know, can approach that whichever way I want.
Yeah.
But I think that in social media, what we're seeing is however people are doing things, we can't help but compare ourselves to.
Right.
Right. And so even in spirituality, even in, you know, fucking food, exercise, everything that I feel like I need to always work actively on, it's hard not to compare. And so for me, the way out of a negative spiral is to be of service. And right. So the way I can be of service looks different than the way maybe you can be of service or anybody else, you know? And I think it's important, whatever way you think you can help right now, do it anyway. And that's why I think women like you are so important, is because I do believe in the vibrations of the planet. And I do think women like you are teaching other people how to raise their own vibrations. Mm-hmm. And that's so important universally for this planet right now. And any way that you can offer that to the masses should be hugely echoed.
I agree with you on all of that. You know, I had a friend of mine once say to me, I can't stand Tony Robbins. I just can't stand him. Everything he says. And I'm like, he literally saying exactly what I'm saying. I take his seminars. What are you talking about? You don't like Tony Robbins? He's like, I just can't hear him. And it's just, it's exactly the reason why I think you're absolutely right, is it's just kind of like some people might be able to hear it through me, through you, through Kim, through Oprah, you know, and other people.
Oh, true.
Like, but I need Eckhart, man. He speaks to my soul.
I love Eckhart.
Someone's like, they're great, but Brene Brown is my bitch.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Or whichever. And that is, so even if you think you're doing like the exact same thing as somebody else, your particular spin on it, like when I did my meditation, I'm such a nerd, as you know.
Give it.
And I'm just like, no, it's like that moment in Star Wars, A New Hope, when Luke Skywalker is, you know, being told by Obi-Wan, you know, use the Force. And he still wants to use his navigation. And you're like, no, the Force, what's inside of you? Use that to do the navigation.
I never thought about that.
And I was just like, yeah, man. And so I was like, that's what we need to do now. It's like, we can't look to the outside world for our navigation anymore. We've actually got to go in and use our own force, our own energy.
And I think that's what this is for. I do.
You know, me too. I think this is a spiritual battle as much as anything else. And
truly.
And so in that regard, it's like people were like, the minute you said that, you know, I got it. I was
truly
able to understand it. And I was like, but a lot of spiritual teachers aren't trying to bring you into Klingon land or
I know.
Or talk to you about Star Wars. And so, you know, like my particular brand of spirituality is so mixed and intertwined with like Lord of the Rings and Star Trek and, you know,
but it's all the same. Like Jose's the same, you know, like Jose's a big Star Wars nerd and he's a, you know, Reiki master. And so it's all the same. It's the same thing, just different verbiage. So you're so right in going, however you hear it, however you invoke it, do what you need to do. Just do it and realize that you do have the power. You do. You truly do.
Yeah.
Now you had offered to maybe take us through something.
Yeah, I mean, it's if you're totally gay, I love your face, because it's nighttime over here, so it's kind of like wind down time, and
yes,
wind down time. And like, I'm like, I don't drink anyways, but that was a good pun. And I'd love to take you through just a simple
please breath, do. I love a it.
Breath meditation. So anybody who's watching, yourself included, Brianna, just exhale and get comfortable. If you so feel inclined, then close your eyes. You don't have to. Bring your awareness inward and relax all of the thoughts that you have by focusing on the inhale and the exhale of your breath. And just connect to yourself inside. And there's nowhere that you have to go but inside. No one that you have to be but yourself. And there's nothing you have to do right now but relax. And just begin by having a conversation with your body, and just let her know and him know, depending on who you are, that you are going to be practicing becoming more aware of it. You're going to be asking questions, and that you're going to be listening for any of the answers. And so just gently allow every breath to make you a little bit more relaxed, to let you a little bit more settled, to let you feel a little bit more calm. And just ask yourself real gently right now, body, what does it feel like to love myself from the inside out? What does it feel like to love my toes from the inside out? What does it feel like to love the heels and arches and the balls of my feet? What does it feel like? I'm paying attention. Let me know. What does it feel like in my ankles? And if there's any kind of release, let it happen. What does it feel like in the lower part of my legs? Moving up the body, what does it feel like in my knees? And in the top part of my legs. And at the base of my spine, around my sit bones. What does it feel like to love myself from the inside out? And moving up the spine and into my torso. What does it feel like to love myself from the inside out? Around my heart, into my shoulders, down my arms, into my elbows, into my forearms, into my wrists, into my hands, my fingers, the tips of my fingers. And what does it feel like to love myself from the inside out around my neck? What does it feel like to love myself from the inside out around my head? The back of my head, the front of my face, between my eyebrows, around my eyes, my cheekbones, my nose, my jaw, my mouth. And just allow yourself to feel what sensations are coming up. Your body is trying to have a conversation with you right now. It's giving you answers. And everything you need is already inside you. And just ask yourself one more time, now that you've connected to all parts of you, what does it feel like to love myself from the inside out? Everything we feel passes through us first. So if we want to give love, we must be love. Now gently ask your body to remember this feeling and to remind you of it when you feel tempted to be disconnected from it or return to feeling fractured in any way. Just gently thank your body for the answers that it's given you, whether it's letting you know where you hold tension, where you've been able to release. Your body is a sanctuary, it's your home. And you've just opened all the doors and opened all the windows. And your breath is like the breeze just gently flowing throughout the house. Take a deep breath. And in your own time, open your eyes. I love you.
I love you. I kept checking because I was like, they're going to cut us off soon. I don't know if that's true or not. But 220 people stayed with us for that. That's a lot of people. That was incredible.
Thank you.
Thank you. You're so gifted and you so clearly have found why you're important on this planet.
Oh my goodness. I'm so grateful for you. What you're doing is so amazing. It's so wonderful, you know, and it's inspiring. And I'm just so grateful I know you and to be friends with you because it's
same. It's such a gift. I think it's meant to be, honestly, the fact that our paths have crossed for a second time and we're both such different women.
How wild is that? And to be on different coasts as well. And all of a sudden, it's like, that doesn't even matter.
No. Doesn't matter. That's the thing. That's the thing about this is like we can still stay connected. It takes a little bit of effort, but we can still do it.
Oh my goodness.
Okay, Mama, I'm gonna let you go because I feel like they're gonna cut me off. Instagram is like, you get an hour. I love you. I'm so glad that you are so well in this life right now with that little bean in your belly. It's such a beautiful home for that little bean. Even just doing that meditation, I kept thinking, oh, that baby is so lucky. When I was pregnant, I was like, what the fuck am I going to do with this? And then you're just like, no, shh, you're good. You're okay. You're okay. It's going to come into this world like ready to fucking take on anything. And that's how I feel like most humans should feel. So good on you. Keep it up, baby.
I love you.
I love you.
Have an amazing night.
Thank you so much for staying up for me.
Oh my God, anytime. Anytime.
And I'll text you in 5 minutes.
I love you.
Mwah. Bye, Lisa Berry. Friends, neighbors, that was incredible. I almost fell asleep. That's my third meditation of the day. Walking meditation when I wake up. I do a lying down meditation in the afternoon. This is my third one. It's my second drink, third meditation. It's called balance. All right, my friends. I shall see you off with a tarot read, shall we? Staying on a little longer than usual, you lucky fuckers. If you can hear, my husband's making eggs in the kitchen. Oh, and there's my buddy Jameson. Yes, I'm coming. I'm coming. I told him I'd meet him for a drink. In the park, 2 meters apart. Oh shit. Not in the park. Are we allowed to do that? No, not in the park. Not in the park. okay. Friends, neighbors, tell me when. You know the deal. Tell me when. I'm waiting. Last time it took too long. There we go. Thanks, Mandy. Boom. This is the death card. Is this the second time this has come up in 3 episodes? Has this come up before? Do not be frightened. The death card is not a bad card to get. This is what it looks like. This card is a little scary. I get it. Death card's not bad. The death card is actually quite in tune with what Lisa and I were talking about, which is no surprise because every time I pull a card during one of these lives, it's so right on. Ready? A significant end. The time is finally here. It has been building for a while, but it's really happening. The death of something significant. A spectral horse appears staring directly into your eyes. A cold silence descends as you stare back, knowing and accepting the inevitable. Though it seems imperceptible now, like the trees in winter forming this threshold, there will be new life. Things will be lost, sacrificed, and exposed, but you must embrace this purification fully. A new future awaits. I mean, like, is that not exactly what we've been talking about? I just think that it's kind of crazy that we've been talking about this pandemic and how it's like time to rid ourselves of things we don't need that don't serve us and bring what does serve us into our lives. 2-2-2. So that's good. And I feel like that's a great way to end it. Can you guys see how sweaty I am? Okay, great. Yeah, so tarots for the happy hour have thus far been 3 for 3. This is Take Me Home Country Road by Mountain Man. Not a man. I love you all. Thank you so much for joining me. I do these lives because I feel the need to be connected as much as I can. I hope you feel that need too. Take this feeling and spread it any way you can, 6 feet apart. We are all one. That's a weird thing to say, but it's true. So wrap your head around that. I love you. Until next week, lovers. Mm-hmm.